So if you could just tell us a little bit about yourself and what your name is.
Okay, my name is Roger Carvalho, and I run a company called Snoobies, which is a digital magazine showcasing short films and giving background behind-the-scenes information about the cast and crew.
And how long has Snoobies been running for?
We launched October 2013, so we're less than a year old.
Brilliant. And what does your average day at Snoobies consist of?
We watch a lot of films, obviously, so we get direct submissions via the website, but we also scour the web and film festivals ourselves to just get new content, because we're really quite particular about the type of films that we feature. And so it's always just watching films. There's a lot of work in on a technical side as well. I develop the app myself, so there's always some technical bug somewhere or some issue that you need to work around, so a lot of coding in both the app side and the server backend side. Then there's Apple. I mean, they're a great company to make great products, but they're quite particular on what they allow in the App Store and the way they kind of report on data. So there's always a lot of back and forth with Apple to make the product run smoothly and find out how the sales are going and what you can expect. Other than that, a lot of promotion. We do Facebook advertising, we do stuff on Google, and we try to be everywhere, like events at least tonight, to just let filmmakers and film lovers know we're out there and building up our brand.
And how did you get to the point where you were creating Snoovie? What happened for this to come about?
Okay, so I studied business before, and then I ended up working for telecom operators like Vodafone, O2, etc., and was working a lot on app products and mobile services on smartphones. But after a while, I got really bored and I was really frustrated with my life, and I decided to do something completely different, and I went to drama school to become an actor. And so I finished drama school, and I was doing fringe plays here and there, short films here and there, and it was great. I was much happier, but I was struggling to pay the bills. As we all know, creative industries are quite hard to kind of make a living out of in the early stages. And so I thought, how can I combine my previous experience in mobile and app development with my newfound passion, which was film and theater? And so I thought, you know, every time I do a short film or one of my friends does a short film, we have a screening and everybody loves it and everybody thinks it was amazing. But then the film hardly ever gets seen anywhere. It goes to festivals and then that's kind of dies and people move on to the next project. And I thought, why not try to get these films seen by the whole world and try to build a whole new media format that has an equal right to exist as features? And that's kind of what the mission is of Snoobies.
Brilliant. And how did you get your collaboration with the rest of your team?
We all went to drama school together, so we knew each other from drama school. And basically, I initially started working on a similar startup through a startup weekend with other people working in technology and product management. But we had different ideas of where the product needed to go. So I formed a new team and I asked people that I knew were good at writing, were good at film selections, etc. And so I ended up with Fee and Karsten.
So what sort of an audience does Snoobie have?
We started off with a quite ambitious target. The reason why we didn't call it blah blah short film magazine is that we believe that when you talk to people about short film, they always think, oh yeah, that's for these actors and these artsy-fartsy people that like film and stuff. And we thought, you know, I think these films have potential for everyone that likes film. And so we came up with the brand Snoobies to create a global new media format of short movies that everybody can learn to love and could watch anytime and anywhere. So we launched it initially globally, and it was really surprising to see that the first day that we went live, our biggest customer was China. Because China apparently has a lot of iPhone users that love films and they like the idea, and they just kept downloading it. And then over time, we saw people pop up all over the world, Latin America, the US, obviously the European countries, etc. And from the second issue onwards, we also started to get film submissions from global audiences. So we featured a Swiss film, we featured a couple American films, we have a Spanish language film that was shot in Mexico. And basically our objective is to become global and to remain global and to have films that resonate to a global audience, no matter what language they're in. And so nowadays, most of the films are based in English, and then we have English subtitles for the films that aren't in English. But we're even thinking about building in some features where subtitles depend on which person downloaded the app and which country they're in, and they can actually change subtitles like they can on DVDs. So we really want to remain a global product.
What's next for Snoovy?
What's next? Something pretty exciting. At this point in time, we release issues bi-monthly, every 2 months. We want to increase that frequency, and we also want to be able to target customers more specifically. So initially, we just said anyone that likes films should download Snoovy, and we'll continue to say that. What we also want to focus on now is film industry professionals that work on film on a daily basis, that might be looking for a crew on a production that they're working on, or might be looking for specific talent in film, casting directors, etc. To really start targeting them, contacting them directly, and then hopefully becoming a platform for young filmmakers and beginning filmmakers. When you create a Snoovy, not only do you get the whole world to see it, but you actually also get, you know, the people that this are very difficult for you to reach to see it, and that might get you a job in the future. So that's something that we're really going to be focusing on for the next couple of months.
And are you looking to sort of commercialize it by getting known filmmakers on board, or?
Yes, definitely. So Snoovy is open for everyone, no matter what experience you have, as long as the story resonates and the story works, we'll feature it. And it should be on both sides. So on the one hand, it should be the general audience that just loves film, that sees, you know, this major actor or actress or this major filmmaker do something. I mean, some of the films that we featured already have quite some names attached to them. But on the other hand, we also want the opportunity that names that appreciate film get to see up-and-coming professionals that don't have a name yet, and give them a name, basically, because of what they've seen. So playing both sides.
Brilliant. So what advice would you give to students who are about to set out in a career in film or film business?
What I would say is, and some of the stuff that was said tonight really resonated with me, just do it, you know. Don't wait for someone to give you an opportunity. Take the opportunity. Create anything that you care about, anything that you think deserves to be told, and then just put it out there. I mean, YouTube is great. It's difficult to get a lot of views out of that, but YouTube isn't the only way. You know, Snoovies is a way, Talent House is another way. There are so many ways. Create something and then just put it out everywhere you can. And yeah, some film festivals might not accept it, but to be honest, film festivals is only one way. There's a lot of people out there that have made brilliant careers out of film without ever submitting to a single festival. So be open to just get your work seen, and then the rest will come.